You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
The Super Dragon Ball Heroes Big Bang Mission anime episode number 11 is now officially in the history books, and now, following the events of Limit Breaker Super Saiyan 4 Broly having to battle against both Limit Breaker Super Saiyan 4 Vegito and Capsule Corp Super Saiyan Blue Vegito, it looks like we finally now have the conclusive end of the Big Bang Mission arc, which the brand new arc called the New Space Time War arc is gonna start literally next month. And guess what? In this arc teaser, we actually get to see the return of Goku Black, but now, we have a different variation. We have Time Breaker Goku Black, who's going to be a thing, and we also have the first ever duo of Golden Frieza and Golden Cooler, who just so happen to wield the Dark Star Dragon Balls inside of them. So we're gonna have some wacky stuff kicking this off, but right off the gate, if of course you guys are new, then I do encourage you guys to hit that subscribe button. Also give this video a big fat thumbs up if you guys simply love to watch these out of pure enjoyment, only because this episode kicked things off with Fiu having to finally get what he needed out of the Universal Seed and getting the opportunity that he just so desperately had wanted in creating a brand new universe, right? So that is Fiu's MO. And it's interesting because in this episode, he's holding this dark rift in his hand, this dark spherical like energy ball, and he's speaking sort of as if his plans are now finally complete, but Limit Breaker Super Saiyan 4 Vegito had had enough, so he goes on the attack. And it just blows my mind to see the power scaling aspect of these episodes, because nothing makes sense, right? I mean, nothing is ever made to make sense to begin with, but you guys get what I'm trying to say, right? So Limit Breaker Super Saiyan 4 Vegito looks incredible, and he's trying to attack Dark Demon God Fiu, and every single time he's trying to attack him, every single time he's trying to get to him, it looks like Fiu is kind of making mockery of him, right? And we're only taking into account how strong a concept like this would be, right? So Dark Demon King Fiu, he's ducking, he's dodging, he's avoiding all of Vegito's attacks, and what's even more interesting is he lets this little spherical object hover up in the sky, and as he did, he then went on to attack Vegito, which again doesn't make any sense because narratively, it would be implied that Vegito would be stronger, right? But nonetheless, it's a really cool fight. I don't know what happened with this entire arc. This entire arc, to me, was really, really boring. I really enjoyed the Universal Conflict arc with Zamasu and Cumber and Hearts. And speaking of Hearts, it looks like Goku and Hearts are going to be working together to fight Golden Frieza and Golden Cooler in the next arc. So I have no idea what's about to happen, but it sure as hell looks a lot better than the Big Bang Mission arc. So, as of course we get to see how this energy sphere is up in the sky, Fiu is basically talking a whole lot of crap to Vegito, telling him how he's going to create a new universe, and how he's going to destroy the remnants of the multiverse. So, a lot of things are basically alluding to Fiu carrying out his mission into the next arc, which I think that, when looking at this objectively, they're dragging this out with Fiu to the point where it's either you destroy him or you don't, right? So what's even more is seeing how Toa had revealed herself to Demigra, and they kind of seem to have like a plan to do something involving the demon realm, right? So again, all of this just seems like a whole big facade because they're all transforming back into their original kind of demon outfits, which is pretty cool nonetheless, because a lot of us do want to see more of these demon concepts be adapted, especially one day, hopefully, in Dragon Ball Super, right? But nonetheless, Toa ends up fighting one of these demon characters, which again is really cool because we have a demon fight happening on the ground, all while Vegito is fighting Fiu. So, interestingly enough, I think in my position, Vegito should have been able to finish this dude off no problem, right? Because we saw how badly he was getting beaten by Blue Vegito, and Limit Breaker Vegito prior to Broly arriving, so it did look as though he was having sort of like a tough time, and the fight was really cool. The fight was a lot better than anything we've seen with stupid Turles and Bojack and all these other guys that they threw in there, because, again, they propped this up as being as though it was a be-all, end-all fight, especially with Vegito using his energy blade, which I will say was really, really cool, and the animation was really crisp. This was, if anything, one of the better episodes, but again, it's just filler, it's just promotional material to, I guess, sustain the fandom in a sense. But Demigirl, what he ended up doing, what I thought was pretty cool, was he ended up sealing these two in somewhat of like this time cage or time dome. It was really, really cool because I don't think we've ever seen that before, because the way he stopped them was you see these gears and these like clocks all around them or whatever. So that was a really cool thing until we saw how they left. So they froze Fiu and Vegito in place and they just bounced. However, when going back to Beerus's planet, I just love seeing the angels together. I love seeing the gods together because it looks as though Vodalus was talking to Whis about how she senses that there is another disturbance in outer space, right? So what's even more is seeing how Ciampa and Beerus were together and these two cannot possibly get along, right? So clearly enough, the angels are beginning to detect something out in space, and we get to see how that little sphere is now really beginning to glow and get bigger, and through it, we see something on the other side. So as soon as we then get to see how we go back to Earth, what's even more is Goku is on the floor. So somehow Goku's alive, Capsule Corp Goku that is, right? So he was separated from Vegeta, he wakes up, he's all battered and beaten, and he goes on to look up. So what's even more is Goku was sent to this different, apparently a dimension, because it looks like Earth, it functions like Earth, but there are so many planets that are around this planet that Goku's kind of wondering as to what the heck is going on, because everything looks the same, but clearly enough, it's different. So by the time this episode ends, it ends with the assumption that there's going to be something coming, which of course there is, because as soon as Goku then encounters Hearts, because Hearts is the first person he encounters, it looks like there's going to be somewhat of an engagement between them. However, the main point here is seeing Golden Frieza and Golden Cooler versus Hearts and Goku. But there is also this mysterious figure that seems to be cloaked under this robe, and we really don't know who he is. They were promoting all of these new cards and all these new concepts, but the actual main point here is by the end, they set up this narrative to where not only are we going to see Omen Goku, Hearts, Cooler, and Frieza, but we're also going to be seeing Time Breaker Goku Black. Now, I don't know what this means going forward. I don't know what they intend to do with Goku Black's character, but given the fact that Goku Black was a very popular character, I'm so happy to finally see him out of all people, only because I felt as though I liked Goku Black a lot better than how I did with Merge Zamasu, right? So Goku Black is back, he's wielding the Time Breaker mask, and he is going to be ridiculously busted. I mean, even though he kind of looks like Time Breaker Bardock, I'm not entirely sure if they're going to change his outfit or if he's going to be given a new form, but nonetheless, Goku Black is coming back and he looks incredible. It's just a matter of propping up the narrative to set up a good story. But in the end, I want to get your thoughts on the episode. I want to get your thoughts on the duo involving Frieza and Cooler and just your overall expectations going forward. So again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. If of course you guys enjoyed, then be sure to give this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below. Tune back in for more. For me, I want to say that there is so much potential for the next arc, only because this arc was so boring and it was so dragged out that I honestly believe they could ultimately do a better job by giving us something better and something more consistent, but not with the way they were doing it, because there were specific episodes where the animation was complete ass, and the overall, I would say, narrative behind everything was just really, really slow. So again, I want to get your thoughts if you guys enjoyed it. Thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. If, of course, you guys are new, smash that subscribe button. Give this video a big fat thumbs up. And I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network, which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life and taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so very much for your support, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck, Zarbon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes. Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Freezer.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm a real gaming! But once you get video, I'll lots of likes! Or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Vados, get over here! Tell these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Engine gaming fan! This is my moment! I'm a part of his notification squad! Universe 7 can have all the fun! I just want the food!
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video! Show some love for the best community on YouTube!
Kakarot!